The medical field, you need to understand it well. The medical practice came from the Jewish and Greek culture, where some people with supernatural abilities to heal, of course connected with demonic powers, were now being, engaged to come up with solutions of diseases and sicknesses in those days. And so pharmakia was partly was translated to mean sorcery, medicine men, magicians. So those things were acceptable in the systems of governance that time. That is why you see a king calling the magicians, calling the soothsayers, and they all came together. They could foretell the future. They could tell whether somebody is going to be healed or not. Remember the king who sent men to the god of Ekron with only one question: go and ask the god of Ekron whether I am going to be healed or not. And they met Elijah the Tishbite, and he asked them, is it because there is no God in Israel? And I'm asking you the same question. Is it because there is no God in this nation that the church has to be closed? That the believers, they believe in nothing. They don't call upon anyone that can help the government to tackle the problem that we find ourselves in. Then I send you back to the one who sent you. God, tell him that he is not going to come down from the bed of sickness that he has climbed, but he shall surely die. Tell him to put his house in order, says the Lord. Listen to me carefully, children of God. Is it because there is no God in Israel that he sends you to inquire from the God of Ekron? And the man of God said, go back to him with this message. He is not coming down. And then they tried to send men to go and capture Elijah the Tishbite. That is when he said, if I be a man of God, let fire come down from heaven and consume you and your 50. I tell you the truth, the policemen who went up the altar to disrupt a live broadcast of the message of God, they will never have normal lives. They will never. It will never happen that they have a normal life. No, it will never happen. The messenger and the one that sent him, if the messenger be foolish, the messenger dies in correction. The first captain with his 50 was consumed with fire from heaven. The second captain and his 50 were consumed by fire from heaven. The third messenger was wise than the first two messengers. And the man came and he knelt down. And he said, oh man of God, spare my life. Let my life and the lives of the ones that I've come with be precious in your eyes. I know the previous ones have been consumed by fire. And I tell you this, the pastors who are saying, please forgive them. Have mercy on them. You don't know the God of heaven. The God of heaven is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He is in the business of forgiving those who require and desire forgiveness. He is in the business of punishing those who require and need punishment.